I feel like if you're not living for goodness and healing and peace and everything that comes along with prayer, what's the point?
And welcome to interview number 10 of Whatever. And today I have a very special guest, Rebecca Pink. How are you, Becca?
I'm doing all right, Paul. Thank you.
Great. And Becca, where are you from?
I'm in New Bedford, Massachusetts, about 10 minutes away from a beach.
Is that where you're from as well?
Yes. I was born in New Bedford, and I lived in Dartmouth growing up, which is one town over. So,
okay.
Yeah, I've always been in this area.
So you've always been a New England girl then?
Yep.
Awesome. And have you lived anywhere else?
No, I've considered it, but I've never had a job that moved me away.
Okay.
I think at one time, if I had had an opportunity, I would have lived in California. I've gone to California many times and I love it. So
awesome.
Yeah.
So Becca, what do you do?
I'm a professional singer, and I put together actually now a program for nursing homes and adult living community. It's about an hour long, and it's called Broadway and Beyond. And I was to get into it, very inspired to do this program. It was at a time I had a job that didn't work out, and I was sitting in my home, and I had one of those moments. I let it, you know, I just sat at my desk, and I was feeling pretty lost, and not really depressed or whatever, you know, but just really like, oh, okay. Like, I lost this job. I don't know what to do. And I just had that moment. It was like a spark of light, and I don't know where this came from. It was like, well, I know where it came
from. You know
from.
Where it came from.
Yeah, it was really inspired. And I told people within a month, I got a speaker, which wasn't a crazy amount of money, a real portable speaker. I put together a set list. I was ready to go in about a month. And I went around to all the nursing homes. I introduced myself. I made posters. I was like up and running in a month. And that was about a year ago. And since then, it's been great. It's like, it's one of the best things I've ever done with my life. And never thought I'd do. Never thought I'd do that with music.
It's really cool when God just sort of brings us where we need to be. And we feel like, oh wow, this is exactly what I need, and you know.
Yes.
So and also I can attest, I was at your concert at the BA and it was wonderful, and the residents really enjoyed it thoroughly, and I definitely felt like it was God in action. So thank you for that.
Yes, you're welcome. I had a good time. That was a special day.
Yeah.
That was really just being in that environment. And I always feel like, you know, I reached out to talking about my association, and little did I know they're listening in Indiana, and they were listening all over. And just to be able to be in front of a mic and talk about science and what it means to me. So that in that respect, that concert was really special.
Yeah. So did you grow up in a Sunday school, or did you come to science later in life?
No, I came to science later. I my grandmother, who passed when I was fairly young, I believe she studied Christian Science, and my mother did. But my mother, it was funny, would work with practitioners. Like we had a practitioner growing up, but my mother never really, I don't want to use the word push, but she didn't really get us to get instruction or really talk about it much. Although I found in my 30s, I just kept naturally talking to my mother more about it. And I have a brother who studies science. My sister recently passed. We were all getting into it very late. And in my 30s, one Christmas, my brother who, I had a brother who also passed in his 30s, he had bought me science and health and a Bible set. I remember crying, and my whole family's like, what is that? Like, I needed it. So anyway, I kind of got into a little and back out, and I really started seriously studying science in my 50s, but at that time, I think I got to a point in my life, and it always made sense to me, but my life came to a point, nothing else makes sense except this. Like, there is no other.
Right.
There is no turning. Okay, there's that one road. That's what I want.
How did you make Christian Science your own then?
I had talked to a practitioner, and I had quite a healing, the instantaneous healing, and it was major. And she said, I think she had said to me when we were on the phone, I won't be available. I'm going to be teaching my class. And I was like, class, what's that all about? And she explained it to me, and I went, oh, that's interesting. And so she was letting me know ahead of time, sure. This was a couple months, she was saying, I was thoroughly interested. And so I asked about it, and I got into class. And when I went to class, I felt like another world opened up. Just this world of love, of, again, just dig. Now I'm digging in. Now I'm in. I always say I'm in it to win it.
Right.
That's how, what I mean, for a better lack of a term. But that's things great. Started. It was beautiful, Paul, because, all the previous classes and association, they're praying for you on the way there. I can't even explain what happened and who I met on the flights down there and who I talked. I had a free day before we started class, and I end up talking to a gentleman, and I just like, what is going on? And the whole experience of class, I did my lessons when we left, we'd have our work for the night. I'd do it in at night and again in the morning before class. It was just wonderful. And
that's
I'm
awesome.
So glad I do it. And I'm at a point now, that was 2013. So it's been
awesome.
A while, but that was my path, how I really got into studying. And
so I think we can guess the answer to this, but Becca, why are you a Christian Scientist?
I feel like if you're not living for goodness and healing and peace and everything that comes along with prayer, what's the point? What's the point of living a life where you believe in fear, or you believe that you don't believe in goodness, or you don't strive to? What are you learning? I can't, and I talk to my brother a lot about this now, Paul. I can't fathom another life, and I don't want to. Because to me, it's like having this beautiful, deep ocean, and you're like sitting at the shore, and you never go in. What's it all about, It's living in love, and not that, I think we all have to watch it, selfishness or motives or something, but
sure.
to live in and in love and striving for that. And even sometimes praying, even if you're praying for something personally, when that, you know, for a healing, but for to turn that outward and let that prayer go out into the world and know that you're healing.
Yeah, that says it all right there, Becca.
Yeah.
Okay, my favorite part of the interview, let's talk about what's your whatever that you want to talk about today.
All right, my whatever, I think, is I will say volunteering. And I should actually say anything that is reaching out. And I started volunteering, this is quite a few years now, maybe 20, 25 years ago, and for a local shelter program called Habitat for Cats. And we it's TNR. So we take colonies of feral cats, and they're afraid of, they haven't had human contact. They're afraid. And we trap neuter and release them back into their colony, make sure they have care. We also have a sanctuary. So I've fostered many cats. I fostered like 80 cats now in my life. Yeah. But the whole thing of volunteering, I think, whether you're a Christian Science or not, gets you away from doing anything for any benefit of your own. So it's really a complete outreach.
It's that selfless love, right? That agape love when you're giving to others. It's who we are, right? It's the substance of our being. And so, of course, you're going to feel fulfilled, right?
Yes. And I feel like I wish I had done that younger, because I think in, especially in this world of, you know, show me the money,
right,
the materialism. And so it's like, do something that has nothing to do with, are you getting anything out of it? Anything.
So why do you love this volunteering efforts? Why do you love it?
Besides the fact I love cats. I love cats. I always laugh. And I actually used to tell my Mrs. Pat Hyatt, my association teacher, you know, and I'd say, I don't know, I think God, one of God's best ideas was cats, you know. They're just, and in animals, I have to say, are very in the moment. I think one of God's, you know, creating that different animals to show us to just live in the moment. They never worry. They don't apologize for who they are. They're not regretful or living in the past. And so, yeah. But I was going to say the volunteering, very similar to association or church, talking to people like I'm talking to you today, very like-minded and like-hearted, you will connect with people, volunteers that change your life. Because again, I ended up doing fostering. I never thought I could do that. Very hard the first time to have an animal in your home and say, again, this selfless endeavor, I have to let this go. I have to let this pet find the right home. And whew, that was not easy. So growing in selfless love, growing in your abilities, these wonderful volunteers push you. I did concerts. You know, for them, it's just gone on. It expands your world in the best way. So
you've pretty much answered how you've grown spiritually because of it. So, but have you had any healings associated with this volunteer work?
With the volunteering? Well, I've had healings with pets. I have called practitioners, and I have had healings with pets that have been wonderful, because when you're adopting out a pet, there's a lot of legalities. And I've never had a pet come through my home that wasn't adoptable, which is wonderful. And that was all prayer. A lot of it was, you know, prayer, that all these concepts of pet illnesses, you know, like they do with the medical with people. Watch out for this. Watch out. It's the new and the latest. And this, it's just been wonderful healings for pets. So
that's awesome. Becca, you have been, this has been like the best interview. I love your story. I love what you do for a living. I love what you're volunteering. I love your perspective. God is amazing. And I'm grateful for your story. And I'm grateful that you came on with us today. And thank you very much for sharing.
Thank you. This was, yeah, you always learn something when you put something good out there. So, yeah, I appreciate it. I appreciate you inviting me and taking the time. And it's great.
Awesome. All right. Well, you have yourself a great rest of the day, okay?
You too. Now I got to walk my dog. It's another pet we could talk 5 hours about, right? But I'll let you go.